In the last presentation, we completed the introduction to flip-flop conversion and also converted JK flip-flop to D flip-flop. We know our 5 steps required for this process, and we are going to see one example in this presentation in which I will convert T flip-flop to D flip-flop by using the same 5 steps. So let's move to this without wasting any time. Our first step is to determine the available and the required flip-flop. So in this case, the available flip-flop is T flip-flop and the required flip-flop is D flip-flop. You can see T flip-flop to D flip-flop conversion. Now let's move to our step number 2, in which we will make the characteristic table for the required flip-flop, that is our D flip-flop. So let's make it Qn D and then Qn plus 1. Now you already know, in case of D flip-flop, the Qn plus 1, the next state is same as the value of D. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now Qn plus 1 will be same as D, so 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is the characteristic table for the required flip-flop. Now we can move to our step number 3, in which we have to make the excitation table for the available flip-flop, that is our T flip-flop. So let's make the excitation table for it. And you already know that in case of T flip-flop, the value of T is the odd ones detector. It means when the Qn and Qn plus 1 is having the odd ones, T is going to be high. So let's compare it. 0, 0, no ones, so T is going to be 0. 0, 1, definitely an odd one is there, so T is 1. 1, 0, 1, and 1, 1, even ones are there, so T is now 0. So we are done with our step number 1, identifying the flip-flops. Step number 2, making the characteristic table for the required flip-flop. Step number 3, making the excitation table for the available flip-flop. Now the step number 4 is to determine the Boolean expression for T. You can do it by any means. For example, you can do it by the Boolean algebra, or you can use your K-map, but I'm going to write it directly because it's very simple. You can see T is high only when Qn and D is having odd number of ones, like you can see in these two cases. So T is simply the XOR combination of Qn and D. So I can write D XOR Qn. No need to make the K-map in this case. So this is our step 4. Now let's move to our step 5, that is the implementation of the circuit. So what is the available flip-flop? T. So we are going to make the T flip-flop now, and we are going to do some changes so that T flip-flop will work as your D flip-flop. T is our input. The clock is definitely there. This is our clock. The two outputs are Qn and Qn complement. Now let's see what changes we need to do. The T is equal to D XOR Qn. So if I say this is my D and I have to take this Qn up to this point like this. This is D, this is Qn. Then this T is the XOR combination. So I need to make a XOR gate here like this. And now you can see the T is what? D XOR Qn. So in this way, the T flip-flop can be converted to a D flip-flop, a very simple way to perform the conversion of the flip-flops. So I hope you now get it more clearly that how to do it. In the next presentation, we are going to do another type of conversion. So see you in the next one.